Everybody, it's Invictus. Time for muted Isaac. There we go. It's time for the binding of Isaac. Repentance, Isaac Victa, Eden Rum. Like, I don't know why the game was muted. I think it was because I accidentally muted it on stream and didn't realize it when I switched over to World of Warcraft tonight. But anyway, yeah. Yeah. Happy Thursday, everybody. We got NFL football coming up tonight. But before we get to that, let's get today's Eden Run, right? Because everybody watches football. Yeah. Everyone's ready to watch. I'm pretty sure that I picked the Rams to win tonight, but I don't like either team. But anyway, here's your meme of the day, brought to you by Finn Ninja. Title of thread was, I made some fan art of Sin and some of his pals, and I absolutely adore this piece. I really like how it was almost drawn on like parchment paper, like cardstock. It's hard to tell, like that really high quality, like construction paper-esque type deal. I'm making all my artist friends out there just hate me right now because I don't know the official term. But we got Sci-Fly, we got Little Sissy, we got D-Bizzle. We got even blood puppies underneath my arms and stuff. It's one of the cutest fan arts ever, and I thank you very much, Finn Ninja 140, and all 107 of you who upvoted that one today. Here we go. Happy Thursday. Like I said, football coming up later on tonight. Yeah, buddy. Today's going to be Kilo 1, Kilo Hotel, Lima Alpha 6 Yankee. We've got Pandora's Box along with Judas's freaking Shadow. And we also have Butter, which I don't think Butter allows us to use Pandora's Box like infinitely, but maybe it will. Also, our shot speed is out of control here for a starting run. We got 3.3 tiers rate. Oh my goodness. We done died and went to heaven, little chub. So, although unfortunately our movement speed is 0.89, and this is not a bit, but like unironically, we saw zero movement speed upgrades in the run tonight on stream, and that was something because, we also had 0.89 movement speed there too, which was, yep, sure was fun. There's the eraser. There's a half price sack here, actually. That's pretty good pickup, especially if we get a bomb, which we did. This will allow us to go into, hopefully, maybe the secret room. I don't know about turning into Black Judas on floor one. That's something that we should save for floor two, although I will say that if we use Pandora's Box now, we do gain 2 soul hearts. Which would be good for Black Judas, because yes, he doesn't gain any red hearts, but he does. You know, that's a good standard. That's a good base to start with. So yeah, we might could. So we wouldn't have known what this card is here, and so I'm not going to use the information mod to scout that out. Plus, I want to go into the super secret room anyway, which had 2 keys and nothing else in there. Secret room might actually be to the left of there. Look at that little chub getting in there, getting some. Good job, little chub. Little chub is a very good source of constant damage. I mean, she flies out there pretty quickly. There's a HP upgrade. It's not. It's a range and damage upgrade. So that's going to be huge for us. I think I am going to turn into Black Judas now. God, it's so tempting to wait though, because like, we could also go Angel Deals. Let's stick with the plan here. I'm gonna go for Black Judas. We get the damage upgrade, we get the movement speed upgrade, and we know that we're going to have the soul hearts that we're gonna get from Pandora's Box. So let's yeet ourselves into Black Judas here. There we go. Yeah, and Butter didn't do anything as expected. So we're gonna gain a huge, huge damage up and movement speed upgrade, which is very nice. And now we're also going to take Synth Oil, which is gonna give us even more damage. And we could look for the secret room, which may be here, and also get this High Priestess card. Hey. Yeah, we got 9 cents going into the next floor. I mean, yes, we could try to do the mega chest, but if you find me a mega chest that opens in 2 keys, I'll find you a lucky lobster. I don't know what a lucky lobster entails. Don't ask me. It's Thursday. There's a double tinted rock up there. So we need two bombs for this to happen, or I could use the High Priestess card. So you notice how that rock cracked once. I knew that was a double tinted rock because if you look at, oh, this is, little Chad could not be more useless. But if you look at that rock before we cracked it with the bomb fly, essentially there's a little dark X on the bottom right. Now, on a standard issue tinted rock, you usually don't see that. You see it on the left. Yeah, keeper's bargain. Yeah, you gotta love this damage though. 2.73 damage, or 2.73 tiers, with a whole lot of damage here to back it up. 10.38 thanks to Synth Oil, and of course us being Dark Judas. Life is good, man. We doing all right. There's our bomb. I am going to go back and use this. Double tinted rocks are almost always worth it. The only scenario that they're not is when they give you a golden chest. Small rock is going to instantly nuke our movement speed, but it does give us a tears rate upgrade, and more importantly, 2.52 damage. So we traded essentially one bomb for a huge damage upgrade, which is always going to be worth it. Get blank Ukado. Yeah, I think we'll pass on that. Oh, the Diglett's over here somewhere. There he is. As a little Chad's going to drop these red hearts that unfortunately we're not going to be able to pick up because, well, we don't get red hearts anymore. Can't get red heart upgrades as Black Judas. That was a thing that was possible up until Repentance. And then Repentance changed that. So now he's much like Blue Baby where you can only gain soul hearts or black soul hearts as a means of HP. Which means that his damage is a little bit, or his HP is a little bit more finite because obviously soul hearts are a little bit more harder to come by than just regular old red heart container drops. Interesting room might be here. No, it's not. Ah, that's right. I remember. We're going to head on over here and fight. By God, it's pinned. By God. Now, the real question is, are we going to take a devil deal here? I mean, I mentioned that our damage, is already pretty good enough. We are going to take eye drops, which... We can go Angel Deal for now. I'm willing to go into the Curse Room. Actually, no. I don't want to go in the Curse Room because if we do, in the unlikely event that we do get teleported to the Devil Deal, it's going to ruin our Angel precedent for the next floor. There is such thing as Angel Deal precedent because now that we have completely refused... the devil deal entirely. We didn't even go into the room. We now are guaranteed to get angel deals until we get one. Unfortunately, we did not get our key back. We got a range upgrade and a soul heart and luck upgrade from Mom's Pearls, which, it's a range upgrade. The luck upgrade and the soul heart are obviously a little bit more important, in my opinion. Movement speed is also quite doo-doo, so we need to do something about that. Need to get one of them there movement speed upgrades. Now we did have again on the run on stream tonight. We did have no movement speed upgrades, but we also found purity. And purity, whenever we would take inevitable damage because we're moving so slow, it would give us occasionally the yellow aura. But I mean, the chances of that happening are very, very slim. And now I've just jinxed myself into seeing purity. Recap. Hey, Liberty Cap could give us a stat up, and we're not using butter for anything, so sure. There you go. This room's easy to run down that the gaper up there, but we need to find a key or two. We can get inside of the shop as well as the item room. Now, where we have the luxury of not having to worry too much if we don't get into either one of those is because we are, obviously, we're Black Judas. So, like, we're going to have the damage to back up the lack of options if we end up not getting a lot of items on this run. We're still, I mean, right now, like, we're still at, like, almost end-game damage, like, levels here. That was just an awful, awful shop. I think after, like, the third shop upgrade, it shouldn't be possible for you to get anything less than two items in your shop. And I mean items. Now, I don't mean, like, a consumable plus, like, you know, a premium item. I mean, like, you should always have two items to buy from after you've upgraded your shop to past a certain point. But that's just me. Still waiting for our Yabe here. We only have one more chance to get it. And we did not. Yellow champion Gertie Jr. I'm not even gonna bother. And I am gonna use two bombs here to check mines. I'm not gonna go down there, but they may have some keys or something. Now, planetariums are a little bit more of a likely scenario since we've skipped a out of room due to lack of keys. We could have taken Fanny Pack and maybe somehow gotten a key out of that if we like chose to take damage deliberately, which is not always a really great strategy. And most of the time, taking damage in Isaac is always going to be somewhat suboptimal, if not always suboptimal. You should learn from your mistakes. Or if you're like me, learn from your multiple mistakes. There we go. Very nice, very clean, very good. Okay, so we're still looking for that item room. Little Chubb just had a field day on those egglets. Eggles. Gonna grab ourselves a golden bomb here, and the golden bomb is gonna give us unlimited bombs for the entire duration of this floor. Now, there's no excuse to finding or not finding the secret room and super secret room. No excuse for leaving behind any mushroom unturned looking for magic mush. I should also mention about that run. This will be the last thing I say about it. That run tonight on stream, it was so bad that it took us 50... It was either 54 or 45. I think it was 45. It took us close to 45 minutes to get to bomb. I mean, at this point, I guess we can buy Mr. Me and he can open up the door to the item room because we're clearly not going to get anything in the store. I know the secret room is here. I didn't know that. Well, I've seen this tile many, many, many times. And that's my answer. Kind of hoping for a key. We do not, I repeat, we do not want to skip another item room. This room in here is a lot better to just do like fadeaways. Get away from the action. What was that glowing? What was that glowing blue? Oh, that was it was a Godflesh tier from Liberty Cap. Oh, I forgot that we had you, Liberty Cap. Apologize. And we can also use Mr. Mizzle to take a devil deal. Now, obviously, we don't have a devil deal precedent yet. We only have angel deals. You get our angel deal. We also got Magic 8 Ball. is going to further increase the likelihood of us getting getting a planetarium here. And yeah, might as well just fight old Gabriel. Okay. Don't know about that one. The hit was to hit the top of Isaac's sprite there. I'm gonna stick with the Bible just because I want to have flying whenever we need it. Plus, it gives us the free mom kill and the free it lives kill as well. Not that we'll probably need it, of course, but it's just nice knowing that we can just like fly right through that.
All right, let's still go back and find that item room, shall we? Now that we've seen the entirety of the map, this is where the fun begins. Wouldn't you know it, the last place we went was the item room. Wow. All right.
I've already found the secret room. Looking for the super secret room. Doubt it. Shadows marks our second book. There's no way that we can do this without taking damage. Unless I use the Alge's rune. Guppy's paw, which is useless to us as Black Judas. I think I might stick with the Book of Shadows. You know what? You can have the super secret room game. I'm trying to make boss rush here. It's gonna be pushing it here. They may have noticed our stats changed by a whole lot in that last room. That was because of Liberty Cat, by the way. Yeah, go on. We need to do is we need to essentially just plow right through this level and try not to get any dead ends. Of course, we have no control over that because we don't have any mapping of any kind. There's a chance that we could get through here without actually taking damage if there was combat in here, which is not. Oh, never mind. I'm an idiot. We could have actually done that. That was a full charge. I thought that was a mini charge, so my bad on that. That was my fault. My fault, Judas. My fault. Sometimes a tinted rock in that room. We do get a planetarium, as expected. Sorry that we skipped one item room, as well as get the Magic 8-Ball. We end up getting Terra, which is a great damage upgrade for us, and also gives us the tier effect that will allow us to just basically destroy doors. So it's kind of like a little bit like, hey, sulfuric acid, let me look at your homework. I promise I won't show teacher that I was cheating. Except Terra actually gives you like a pretty significant damage upgrade. And you also get the rock shots as well, which is kind of nice. Just make satisfying like crunchy, crunchy noises. get our atypical greed fight here. That was close. We get a steam sale, which is prompting us and setting us up for heartbreak, because obviously we're going to get a greed fight on the next floor. I'm fully anticipating it. Don't worry. We get another angel deal, and we got a movement speed upgrade. Ooh, boy. Immaculate Heart with Black Judas and also with Terra is really, really nice. Another 3 damage upgrade. So, and with Terra here, we're going to be able to go through the doors and get to boss rush, I hope. Hope. That's what we're aiming for. Now, why Isaac has a double silhouette right now, I have no clue. The answer is repentance, baby! I literally cannot move. Our movement speed was so low that I could not get away from either that, or there was like there was something blocking me there that I didn't see. I know that we have a soul heart there, but we're trying to get to the boss rush first. We ain't got time for this. Looking for the tinted skull for us. I think that was it in that Loban room. Well, either that or we just hit a random tarot card. Nope, that's it. And then we hit a random tarot card anyway. And also the random regular secret room. And another random greed fight. And a random quarter. Along with a random soul heart. A random 10 bombs? It's so random. Random Eternal Heart? We got a minute left. As long as Mom is in this direction, we'll be able to make it. You're seeing how awesome having Terra is. Me red mom. I spot the Book of Shadows. I know it's hard to see me doing it, and it definitely is a weird way to animate it, but you can sort of see it when it flashes. But right now the duration is gone. Take the negative for another, again, nice damage upgrade. And Vasculitis is just not very good, so I'm going to go with Polydactyl, and then we're going to teleport out. World card, party time. Excellent. Yeah, there's definitely nothing blocking there. Yeah, we were just getting sucked in right down to the corner over there. And again, you're still free to exercise your freedom to skip these rooms here. We don't have to do any of these rooms if we don't want to. I certainly don't see a reason to. That was cute. That was really cute. I liked how the bomb hid perfectly behind Isaac. That one I'm blaming on you there, Isaac. We have here reverse world card, which is going to give us a crawl space.
Soul.
Oh, Bethany. Justice. So we might as well put some money back in the donation machine. Been dinging it quite a bit. Not entirely sure what we got to, but let's use the reverse world card. We didn't have to use it on the art there, but it's fun anyway, because it gives you guaranteed crawl space, which turns into a black market. Oh, baby. And look at that. We're going to be able to get 4.5 volt. 4.5 volt plus Book of Shadows. That is, man, that is. That is certainly something. The Book of Shadows is now going to probably recharge after every room. And we're going to be able to charge it not by the amount of rooms that we clear, but by the amount of damage that we cause. So, yeah. It's about to get pretty nice. Okay, world card. I will go at least see who this mini boss is. World card. The world card is not necessarily all that big of a deal anymore because, like, you know, we have Terra. We have the ability to walk through doors essentially, so exploration is no longer going to be a problem. Although I am having a problem with Sacred or Immaculate Heart hitting those barrels, which again. I hate to keep bringing up an old dead horse here, but controlling your output, controlling where your tears go, that's a big thing. I don't know why I looked for the secret room when I can see it on the map. I don't know why I looked at that spot. I'm used to it being attached to that spot. Look at this. We can go into the curse room for what is free. He's been in kind of a short supply here. My time, we can't get the curse for free. Now we can. And look how fast Book of Shadows actually recharged. We actually can use it again here. There we go. We technically didn't have the full charge walking in here, but I figured that we probably would get something like this, so. There we go. There we go. And then because we deal so much damage, we should be able to get it back. Well, these mobs aren't necessarily tanky enough to get us back a full charge. Let's see if there's anything tankier over here. Yeah, the yellow champions. Plus they also drop, of course, full charges, so. There's a crawl space over there too. Oh my Gertie. You're spoiling me here, game. All right, NFL football. I know. Keep talking about it. Coach Crendor did release episode 1 of season 5 now of the Three Guys Talk About Football podcast. Another HP upgrade here for the low, low cost of 12 cents. Something like that. And we're just going to do it again, I guess. A little chest. Little chest is one of the more unremarkable followers, but, you know, if a little chest pays out, nay, he pays out. Hey, Mr. Fred, I'm just going to go ahead and just run in with Book of Shadow, because we're just going to be able to just get another full charge off of it. We get another angel deal as well, which is just amazing that we're getting this lucky. Unfortunately, we're not really getting much out of it, but you're seeing what I was talking about here with Book of Shadows as well as 4.5 volt. You know, gaining these charges we're now in, as long as we can deal enough damage, we are in an infinite shield possibility realm here. We just have to be able to find targets that we can deal enough that amount of damage to. Get another judgment here. I mean, we're turning these coins into at least like hearts. So, card.
The sun.
Show us the light. Contrary to what some people think, sun card does not clear all curses. Only clears the curse of darkness. In case anyone was curious out there. Don't want to put you on the spot or anything. it's a foolproof way to fool the guts into thinking that they've got a free ride. Destroy their little rock barriers that they rotate around. They don't know what to do. I'll get another just random eternal heart. This is crazy. Use the Empress card here. I have two of them. I can use one. There you go. Keep an eye. Look at the soul of the Book of Shadows. Charge up and up and up. We get another angel deal. And it's pretty damn good. All right, well, we got Godhead, and that's pretty good. Also, we got extra soul hearts here. Now, of course, with us going up against Old Hushy with the 4.5 volt, yeah, we're going to get unlimited uses out of our Book of Shadows. I mean, unlimited uses. Although I did just use all of our keys, which I really shouldn't have done because we need to get into the shop and we also need to get to the item rooms. We also can't get any of these chests, so that was a really smart idea to get rid of those keys. All right, now keep your eye on. Excuse me. Oh, I used that already. Keep your eye on the charge of the Book of Shadows. It should go up and up and up pretty quickly. Assuming that we can hit with the Godhead Aura plus our Terra Tears. If there's anyone named Terra in the mosh pit right now listening, they're probably really confused. All right, two pips into the next Book of Shadows use. They might be asking, well, why are you even fighting Hush at all if you don't have any keys? Well, it's a good question. The answer is I didn't know that we were out of keys until I looked after we came down here. Like looking in the animation of us falling down here. But hey, everybody loves Hush for some reason, so. Because he's old Hushy. Definitely use a higher tiers rate, that's for sure. Again, I'm just going to be popping the Book of Shadows every time it's up. And you can just look at the Book of Shadows. Pips going up and up and up. Almost mesmerizing in a way. It almost looks like its own like energy meter. Trying to time it to where when Hush comes back up and surfaces, we got a shield ready. We don't want to use it while he's underground. But this is another sort of a showcase to show like we just need more tiers. Like our tiers rate is just not good right now. I mean, how often do you get to use Book of Shadows like this often, you know? Now goes old Hushy. No problem at all. Hey, look at that. Little chest. He's sitting here talking trash about a little chest. He drops a bombshell key. Gets us into the store, which gets us more options, which gets us two more keys, which allows us to go into the item rooms. And boy, howdy, was it good. Freezer baby. Miter. Cider's actually really good for Black Judas. Sorry I ever doubted you, Lure Mini Chest. Ryab is lamenting to me about being placed in high ELO Rumbleverse. He and I have been doing Rumbleverse off camera. And he's good. He likes to sell himself short a lot, but you know, Northern Lion is not he's not a bad gamer. He usually excels in the games that he plays. So I told him that, like, well, that's to be expected, I guess, because, you know, you're quite good at it. And, of course, he didn't agree with me, but... Full card, strength card, Hierophant, that's what we're looking for. Power card, I'll probably hold on to the full card in case we need to go back to the beginning of anything. Let's have this Chariot card. Now we can just sit back and kind of enjoy our free ride here, thanks to Book of Shadows and 4.5 volt, and having, like, you know, insane damages with Godhead. Now I know that the Godhead aura is a flat amount of damage now, which is a little bit sad, but it still deals a good amount of damage, and it's just giving us feeding us constant energy for our Book of Shadows, to where we are practically invincible. That's what we want right there. Eye of Belial. This will give us Bookworm as well with Monster Manual. Get a little Monstro. Yeah, but Godhead, piercing Godhead is where you want to be at, because now, on top of us getting our shot damage out of the way, it also guarantees that every target is going to suffer the full wrath of Eye of Belial plus Godhead. Hey, look at that. We got Master Lockpicking. He's going to allow us to open up chests for free. Yeah, you see, you just see and feel the difference. This is a dead end. All right. Why, we held it. So nice they did it twice. We get a Sun card again from Little Chest. Wow. And we were going the absolute wrong direction. Man, this is... I owe Little Chest a huge apology. Not only did it get us options and Mitre, of all things, but also gave us a Sun card so we could see on the last level. I apologize. I formally, humbly apologize and ask for your forgiveness, Little Chest. I shall never... besmirch your name again. Till I do. I need Tapeworm. Oh, come on. And here's what the Chariot card can do. Reverse Chariot, anyway. That goes Lamb! Yeah, let's do that victory lap. We've got Terra. We can run through doors, man. Second seed of the day, Foxtrot Ringo Kilo 9 Echo 9 Quebec Sierra. We've got a excuse me. Thank you. For some reason I couldn't move. I had to click out and click back in here. You know, just like that, we get our soul hearts back, and then some with this Hierophant card, a random soul heart and a half in here, just sitting here. What the heck? Another soul heart. Good lord. Miter, you shouldn't have. Continuum. Now all we're really missing is the is lump of coal. We'll take piggy bank. Well, as dream catcher. Left hand. I mean, we have one guppy item, so it could give us guppy. I hope. Yeah, look at this. Look at the size of these monsters, these meteors that we're shooting out here. I will take the movement speed upgrade because, good lord, we need it. And yeah, let's go see Mother. Now, if you're wondering where we get the double item pedestal from, that was from us getting options. I mean, Nun's Habit, even if we get hit, we're going to just be feeding more and more charges into our spacebar item, which, of course, is Book of Shadows. So we're going to be shielded. We're going to be completely fine. My God. Yeah, well, we'll have to wait on raw liver because I don't want to waste it just in case we get a devil deal here. Oh my gosh. Yeah, those old piercing continuum tears, and we finally get a tears upgrade here as well. And Immaculate Conception, sure. Yeah. Now's when things start getting real tough for the game to do anything about us with. I mean, we could take raw liver, but we just don't need it, man. Like, look how much HP we have. We are absolutely indestructible. We had two bombs, two keys. It saves us 5 cents, so I mean, it's not like that bad. Remember, we gotta go. Okay, so we did not get double deal or angel deal. I am gonna take toothpicks for more tears, and now again, our damage is just going to be off the charts because we have the piercing shots, we have the Eye of Belial, we've got the Godhead aura. Again, with the piercing shots, it's just going to be nightmarish. Now we have to be careful about shooting the mirror. I don't remember if the Terra tears can break the mirror. I feel like they can. I'm not 100% entirely sure on that. I also don't know where our white fire is. Probably next to the item room, like it is right there. Oh, baby. I know what you're thinking.
Victor, how'd you get rid of all your health?
Oh, we get 9 lives. We get 9 lives and HP. I don't know if you've... Oh, yeah. I don't know if you've been paying attention or not. It sounds like you haven't, but HP has not been a problem for us at all on this run. We could easily yeet all of our HP and still get it right back. That's no problem. As long as we don't go down to absolute zero, of course. Yeah, so I need to be careful about shooting in that room with Terra. Something to think about here. I'm gonna judgment. I just had to check. I didn't think that that Terra broke it, but I just wanted to be sure. And yes, I should have done that experiment from outside of here, but... So if you don't know what happens, is that if you break the mirror while you're in the flipped world, you die. You die and there's no coming back, unless if you use the glowing hourglass. Alright, down in the ash pit we go. Normally I would say you want to stay away from ash pit until ash pit 2. Because you're still going to get an opportunity to come down here no matter what. What? Thank you. Oh, there's combat in there. I was right in the head, we don't care about. Only one Guppy item away from Guppy, and if we do end up getting Guppy, oof, it's going to be all she wrote for the game. Definitely don't need Mom's box of friends. Soul hearts here for the price of one. It's clutch. Don't know what that boss does. Oh, yeah, we'll get a wire code hanger, more tears up. Gammy Conception. I mean, it would be nice to have Dark Bum and Sea Bizzle. So we're going to sacrifice a life here just to get, Gammy Conception, or, Yeah, Cammy Conception. It's just like Immaculate Conception, except it gives you devil deals instead of angel deals. The more damage you take, the greater chances that it pays out. It pays out in a somewhat certain order. Somewhat. Got Judgment card here. We still want the left hand. Deep pockets and BFFs. I mean, we don't need BFFs. Wow. I cannot believe how many random soul hearts are dropping because of Miter. Get this done real quick. Only one. Three and a half soul hearts. If we blow up these barrels, they don't actually disappear or anything. They just come right back. Getting a scope out. This room's usually just hit the button and wait for the poop to spawn. In this case, the bridge. Sometimes they switch it up. Deserve that one. I thought I'd be able to sneak it right under her, but I ran out of real estate on this side, and I didn't commit enough to the opposite end to raise my position a little bit vertically, and she got us. That one I don't agree with at all. I apparently have lost the ability to not take damage on the Indiana Jones run. All right. Pop his judgment here and see if we can get an increased chance of something. I mean, shot speed, movement speed is something that I definitely do want. Gonna take it. You do get spun. It's clutch again. And yeah. There we go. We didn't even need we didn't even need the bomb to get the hollow out of there. Hallowed ground, speaking of hollow. What was this card again? Death card. So we get a double card, which is going to give us a Bible effect. Obviously, we can't take red heart damage, so me showing that fire who's boss doesn't really matter. 45%. Missed on the, unfortunately, on the devil deal. We're going to trade another life here just so we can go further into the game. We'll head on to Zaun. Lucky us, we get Mausoleum XL. So unfortunately, this means that we're not going to miss out on at least one possibility for Guppy. Unless we get Guppy, of course. Now, obviously, going back in there and getting Book of Shadows is going to be a little bit trickier because we don't have the ability to guarantee that. But a 68% chance it might come our way. I definitely want it, though, because, again, I'm not sure if you've been... What? Oh, there's a bomb rock in there. I'm not sure if you've been noticing or not, but we've been having a little bit of a death issue here. Primarily from the fact that, like, these are all destroying rocks and stuff, and if there's any hazard underneath it, I'm not going to be able to see it. I also think I saw a little... Did I see another little chub in... in the preview window from Dreamcatcher. Okay. This is good. Two beds in here means that we're going to be recovering 6 soul hearts, which is really, really, really nice. If you don't have any red hearts, red heart containers, you only have soul hearts, you find a bed like this, it doesn't matter if it's a clean bed or a dirty bed, you can get in it and heal for 3 soul hearts, which is a very good tip to have. Okay, we were able to get our Book of Shadows back, so I'm happy about that. Not that Guppy's head would have been like all that bad, but it is nice to have the Book of Shadows shielding you. Just gotta find the item room now. We could probably put the left hand down, although I will say that left hand's been killing it here. Yeah, we've already been in there, game. All right. And just looking for that item room, or item rooms, I should say. Should it be over here? Oh, of course not. Already been in there. What about over here? 10 keys now. We found the shop and one of the item rooms. Gives the everything jar, which we don't really care about. And sure, we'll take chaos. Because why not? You know, why not? Why not get chaotic? It's super chaotic. I am going to still stick with the devil card. Reverse devil card again. Oh, there's a Charles drawing as well. The reverse devil card is going to give us the Bible effect. So it's like we use the Bible, but we don't. made infinitely easier with flying. I'm actually going to take Blood Clot here. The reason being is because, remember, we are Black Judas, so we get a damage multiplier on every damage up that we get. So our every other shot that we're going to be firing out is going to deal increased damage here. And as you can see, very plainly see here by the size of our tiers, we are not hurting in the damage department right now. If anything, we are causing damage from the damage department. Gonna be Heretic, or at least he's gonna try to be. And we'll take Mini Mush. There we go. And we did make Boss Rush again. And yeah. Could take Stye, but the difference between Stye and what we took is the fact that we don't have to do Boss Rush for it. As opposed to Blood Clot, or as opposed, we did not have to do Boss Rush for Blood Clot. We would have to do it for Stye, which I don't want to do. And yes, I could use the Hermit card, but I'm banking on the Hermit card getting us to Mother. Because Hermit cards are clutch, man. Like, Hermit cards, I would even say they're a little bit more clutch than Stars cards, especially recently, at taking you directly to the boss room, even though it says random room. Sitting on a full charge of Shadows, just all right, our movement speed is no longer an issue. It hasn't been an issue for quite a while now, but it is absolutely handled. I'll get the random pact here. Yuppie's Eye and mapping. Sure, we'll take all that. Why not? You know, why not? It's a Thursday. We got football coming up. Hey, have I mentioned that we got football coming up? All right, do your thing. Take us to Corpse 2. And it took us to the curse room, which didn't... Nowhere near the boss room. Got it. Okay. I'm going to say that she's going to be probably southeast, but I'm going to humor myself and go this way. I cannot see myself. Yeah, we're just going to keep getting these rooms, I guess. Yep. Okay. Rooms are lots of joy. Yep. There we go. So thank you for watching, everyone. What a fantastic combo, man. Eye of Belial, Godhead combined with 4.5 volt and Book of Shadows. Just forget about it. Again, look at our space bar item. It's just constantly ticking up and up and up. Yeah, I'm just using Book of Shadows here. No need to dodge. No need to even think, really. It is the ultimate defensive weapon to use against the game. Just unlimited Book of Shadows charges. So thank you for watching, everyone. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you hit that like button down below. I'd love to start seeing the likes coming back here so we can get back on schedule for the like streak goal. A fiend-ish Fridays. And thank you, everyone, for liking, commenting, and subscribing. Have a great start to your Thursday here in the Mosh Pit. And as always, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Langwort, Zerio, Michael Mayette, Nicholas, Alexei Sokolov, and Dylan Beard. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find by going to patreon.com/Sinvicta.